Hi there, my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 6 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So last episode we talked about how you're able to transfer power through logistics pipes to save you the trouble of having to run extra power lines, and today I will be talking about the integration of storage drawers into your logistics pipe network. So let's get started. So as I have demonstrated a couple of episodes ago, you are able to use chests to store a load of items in very different ways, being either the item sync module, polymorphic item sync module, or the default route, for example. But today we'll be talking about storage drawers. Storage drawers is a very common used mod, especially early game, to store all your items very neatly, instead of using something like an applied in logistics network or a bunch of chests everywhere. So this is my little demonstration setup that I got right here. Pretty much I got myself a row filled with compacting drawers and two rows of oak drawers, but pretty much any drawers from the storage drawer mod will work, and one drawer controller. Hooked up to that is a logistics chassis pipe Mark II with a item sync, polymorphic item sync module and a provider Mark II module. And this is all hooked up to my main logistics pipe network. So the cool thing about a storage drawer network instead of using chests is that thanks to the drawer controller, you're able to connect a lot of different drawers to one pipe. So instead of having to use, in this case, over, 5, 10, 30, 33 different chassis pipes with both item sync modules and a provider module, you can all do this with only one chassis pipe hooked up and a drawer controller. The drawer controller is the block that talks to all hooked up drawers in the location. I believe it's 10 blocks in each direction, so I'm actually able to expand it even more if I wanted to, and also up and down, and I believe even, in the depth. So that is pretty awesome. But let's quickly show you how this works. So in general, this system works pretty nicely, but there's only one catch, which is what happens if you leave these drawers empty when trying to put something in. So let me quickly break this, if I want, can break them, so they are no longer hooked up to this drawer controller, and then I will demonstrate this to you guys. So as you can see, if I look into my network, you're able to see that I got 7 blocks of iron, 98 iron ingots, and 576 iron nuggets available, even though in theory I only have a stack of iron. And I believe I do have some iron elsewhere, so let me quickly get that out of the network though, because that's, you know, not something I want to show you guys, as I'm only currently showing you this. There we go. So instead of having only the iron ingots stored somewhere, if you are using compacting drawers, the drawer controller will see all the different varieties of this iron. So like I said, a stack of iron will either be 7 blocks of iron, 7 blocks of iron, or 576 iron nuggets, all in the same block. So if I would, for example, take out 2 of these and then hit refresh, you would see the other 2 also automatically decrease, because of course the general number has gone down. Pretty cool. But it also works pretty nicely with other items too. So for example, if I would get myself some wood out of this, and let me get a stack or so, and put it back into my network, you will see it gets sent out of there and sent into a different route, because of course I am so dumb that I forgot I already set a location for this. Okay, that doesn't work. Let me quickly tidy this up. 1 sec. Alright, fixed it. Yep, on my side. So as you can see, I got myself 64 stone in the network right now. If I would dump in a stack more, you will see it will get sent again to the most logical route, which in this case is the storage drawer, and we'll be putting it in the most random possible location that it has, either a connected drawer or the any possible place that it's able to actually put it in. What do I mean by this? Well, as you can see right now, I had the luck of when the stone went this way, it was put into this location. But that's the only downside with a drawer controller. This thing is not smart enough when interacting with logistics pipes to put it into the only spot that it has. So let me get a couple of packets. So let's send 4 times 16. And let's see what this thing does. Okay, surprisingly it was very smart today. But normally it also has a chance to put it in this drawer instead. And normally in any other drawer. So unless you actually fill every spot in here, so let me also get some dirt, for example. If I would now get some stone and some dirt, and why is it sending dirt over? Am I passively supplying this still? Oh, hey, I am. Derp. You know, that's actually a pretty cool example that automatically still works with this part of the network. But that's not what I want to show you guys. So now what I can do is get myself some stone and some dirt and pop it into the network. And you can see it will all be sent into the same direction, even though there is only one chassis pipe connected to this system. So a better example would be if I would connect all of these machines up and then send a bunch of items this way. So yeah, let's get a couple loads of stacks of stone and send it over. As you can see, in a second, these should be placed in random locations. Yeah, right now they all got placed into this location. So yeah, be sure to double check that if you want to do something like this. But otherwise, a system like this is pretty efficient as it saves you from having a lot of different pipes connected to storage methods. So that's pretty cool. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. I definitely hope you guys enjoyed it and found it very educational. If you have, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. But also, if you have any other suggestions or feedback, feel free to let me know because I always read all my comments. And I want to make the series as helpful as possible for all you guys who like to mess with these mods. So thanks for watching. Please leave a rating, guys. And I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.